So, how are you doing, guys? Do you know what I'm going through in my life? Hashem is bringing down so much light to the world. And I'm very grateful, very happy to know that a lot of this light is coming through me. I have a very big merit, and Hashem Yitbarach, He likes me a lot. And I cannot complain. I'm very grateful, I'm very happy. So those are very, very important days. In the Jewish world, we're calling those days, days of tshuva. It's a month of tshuva. It's a month of coming back to Hashem, preparing ourselves to the big day of Judgment Day, Rosh Hashanah, the first day of the year. And people are usually afraid from this Judgment Day. They're terrified. And even righteous people that were describing this day were describing it with this fear and stress from heaven. And people are trying to explain to other people how really to attach themselves to Hashem and how to connect themselves, how to prepare themselves to Hashem, to that day. And people misinterpret the holy message of Judgment Day and don't understand the real issue of Judgment Day. There is a secret about Judgment Day, about the first day of the year, that the Creator, He decided to set that day to be the first day of the month of Tishrei. So why Hashem decided to make the Judgment Day in the first day of the month, in the first day of the month of Tishrei? Because in Rosh Chodesh, in the first day of every month, Hashem Himself is saying to us a certain thing, a verse, and in that verse He's opening a gate for mercy. The verse is Haviu Alai Kapara, that Hashem Yitbarach is telling us that we need to atone for Him, that we need to bring a sacrifice. In the holy days when we had the temple, we as a nation, Am Israel, we were bringing a sacrifice that would have a certain intention, a certain purpose for that sacrifice. What is that? To atone for Hashem, for the Creator. To bring forgiveness to the Creator. What? The Creator, He needs to be forgiven on something? On what? So Hashem is saying, on the fact that I minimized the moon. Al asher mi'atati et alevana. The moon been constricted, been minimized. In the beginning, in the beginning of creation, God created the sun and the moon in an equal way. They both had the same power, the same size, and the same amount of light was coming out from both of them. But then there was an argument between the sun and the moon. Who will be more important? Who will be the king? So the moon came to the Creator and asked Him, how can it be that two kings will serve and like will be exist in the same level? Why one is not bigger than the other? And both of them wanted to be greater than the other one. So Hashem Yitbarach said, the Creator said to the moon, okay, lechi ma'ati et atzmech, go and minimize yourself, go make yourself smaller than the sun. So today the moon is smaller than the sun. The amount of light that comes out to the world through the moon is much smaller than the light that comes out to the world through the sun. And on that, the Creator regrets. What is the moon? What's the secret of the moon? And what is the sun? And what's the secret of the sun? So the sun is the wisdom and the knowledge. That's the power of the Torah, of the wisdom that's been given to us by the wise people through the generations. And the moon is equal to the faith, is representing the faith. The faith is in the night. The moon is in the night. So the faith today is smaller than the wisdom. Today, to people, it's harder to connect themselves to the Creator through faith than through the Bible. People more likely will try to connect themselves to the Creator while learning Torah and going and talk to rabbis and trying to go to Beit Midrash, to synagogues, and to the things that are, in a way, more external. Because from the Bible, from the books, you can see the light. When you go to Beit Midrash, you have a feeling of holiness, of purity. It shines like the day. But to believe in Hashem, to count on Hashem, to nullify yourself to Hashem, to pray to Hashem on everything, we know how hard it is. It's hard, but it's actually deeper. The nights are much more qualified for people to connect themselves to Hashem in the nights, through the nights. The moment of midnight, the middle of the night, is the highest moment of all, in all the day. The moment of midnight, the moment that the night is break to half, and from that moment the sun is about to rise and the dawn is about to come. So from that moment and on, it's time of grace, it's time of kindness, chesed. So the Creator, He chose the night to bring people closer to Him. So basically, why Hashem Yitbarach decided to put the judgment day in that day of forgiveness for Him? Because He's asking, please atone for me for the fact that I minimized the moon. Why? If, let's say, I made something wrong and I'm coming to you and I'm about to apologize to you and I'm telling you, listen, my friend, I hurt you, I'm sorry. So if you are righteous and you never hurt me and I just hurt you, so then we'll have an issue. It's not fair. Really, what that I did was not right to you. But if you did the same to me, and I will come now to apologize to you on something that you also did, so you will feel embarrassed as well. You're going to tell me, it's okay, you know, I can understand you, I also did the same. So when Hashem Yitbarach, the Creator, He is about to judge us, so He decided to judge us in that day that He Himself feels bad about Himself on what that He did to us, on the fact that He minimized the moon, that He exiled us, that He made certain things that brought the evil inclination to the world, brought darkness to the world. By the fact that Hashem minimized the moon, so darkness came down to the world. Because if not, the moon was supposed to illuminate and to shine in an equal way like the sun. So the night would be shining and illuminating exactly like the night. Like the day. So by the fact that Hashem Yitbarach minimized the moon, so He brought down darkness to the world, because the moon cannot shine as strong as the sun. So we have night. So Hashem put the judgment day in that same day, that in that day He Himself is, so to speak, doing tshuva, feels regret and sorrow on the fact that He brought darkness to the world. So when we are coming and apologizing and crying to Him and asking for forgiveness and asking that He will atone for all of our sins, He cannot tell us, oh, look what you've done, you were so hard, you were so bad, you're doing so horrible, why you did it, why you done that. No, He's not. He feels regret in that day. He's asking, Haviu alai kapara, atone for me. Make forgiveness, help me to bring forgiveness to myself. Forgive me on the fact that I exiled you. And who chose that day? Him. He decided not to be able to judge us in judgment day. That's what He did. He chose the only day that in that day He is not able to judge us, because He feels regret on what that He did to us in that day. And in that day He said, okay, I'm going to judge you on everything you did. Why? Because He doesn't want to judge no one. He doesn't want to judge you. He loves you. So He's going to kiss you on your forehead in Rosh Hashanah. And I'm blessing you to be happy. And Hashem is hugging you. And Hashem, He loves you. And Hashem, He cares about you. And if you think that I care about you, so you don't know anything about Hashem. Hashem cares about you much more than I. Hashem loves you. Hashem is so cute. I cannot talk about Hashem without having tears in my eyes. Hashem is so great. Hashem is so, so great, so amazing, so fantastic. Hashem is such a loving Father. He's such a great, he's such a great person. I bless you to know Him. Okay, too much for one night. Love you. Shana Tova.
It's just a temporary world, that in this world, in this period of time, we have a mission. What's the mission? The mission is only not to forget the Creator, to remember that it's all Him, never to fall in the trap of all of those coverings, of all of those husks.